What we are saying here is that we must shift our thinking. No more emergency solutions to emergency situations. We want a sustainable, long-term vision. Our departing point is that solidarity must be the point of principle upon which any action on migration is based. We draw differences between those who are in need of protection and those who come to Europe for work. Because we understand that while people fleeing war and persecution have a right to protection, it is true that this does not equate to an inalienable right to migration. So we highlight that when it comes to labour migration, for example, it must be the member states who have control over the labour markets, and that they have, and that the union must see how to best fill any possible gaps in the market. Security fears do exist among our citizens, and states must fulfil their obligations at the external borders if these fears are to be in any way allayed. The abolition of internal border controls in Schengen has to go hand in hand with strengthening external borders. This is simply a prerequisite if we are to save our celebrated Schengen zone. We want a new approach on integration. The way forward is having a two-way process. And while, yes, everyone's rights must be protected, and while, yes, we must do more to keep families together, it is also fair to expect people to respect the values upon which our union is founded.
Insistiamo sulla necessità di un meccanismo vincolante ed obbligatorio di reinsediamento di un numero considerevole di richiedenti asilo direttamente dai campi profughi dei paesi terzi agli Stati membri, i cosiddetti corridoi umanitari. Chiediamo delle misure specifiche per i minori, a partire dal diritto all'assistenza legale, sanitaria, all'istruzione, alla tutela e soprattutto alla non detenzione a causa della loro condizione. La nostra proposta è chiara, andare al di là del concetto dello stato di primo approdo. Proponiamo di istituire un sistema centrale collettivo per l'assegnazione delle responsabilità. Un sistema che potrebbe essere concepito stabilendo delle soglie per singolo Stato membro relativo al numero degli arrivi. Non si presenterà più una domanda di asilo in Italia o in Grecia, ma in Europa. Con questa risoluzione noi gettiamo le basi di una politica migratoria comune all'altezza delle sfide del XXI secolo. Sta ora agli Stati membri decidere se seguire la nostra via o decretare il declino definitivo del processo di integrazione europeo. Il futuro dell'Europa dipende anche da quanto siamo in grado di condividere il nostro sogno europeo e i nostri lavori. Grazie.
The current crisis has shown that the present system is not working. And many elements are reflected in your report. We need, in particular, to overhaul the asylum system. But a reformed Dublin mechanism will not alone make our asylum policy more fair and efficient. This is why the Commission will present complementary initiatives in order to achieve greater convergence in the EU asylum system and to limit secondary movements across the European Union. There are many differences between member states' approaches to resettlement. It would be more efficient if EU member states pooled their offers and used the same methodology. We agree as well that in the future we will also need migration to fill skills gaps and to address the demographic challenge that all our nations in Europe face.